Welcome back. If you were tuned in last time, you remember that our initial attempt at underwater exploration didn't go as we planned. I think I came up with a better idea. We're going to build an ROV. That stands for Remotely Operated Vehicle. The idea here is that I can stay up high and dry inside of the kayak or the boat, and the ROV will be our extension of our eyes and our ears really down underwater to let us continue exploration. Let's go ahead and build that out. Okay, so this is the overall system that we have for the ROV. Our primary choice of inputs is going to be joysticks. Those will be interpreted by the user interface processor and give us instant feedback on our segmented LCD display to know what signals that we're sending down to the ROV host controller. Its primary responsibility will be controlling the motor drivers, the LED driver, and anything that we see for expansion in the future. We'll have an eye down in the water with our camera that will feed back up to a monitor. Now that we have a plan, let's go ahead and get started. Meet the testing facility. I guess I'll be spending a lot of time at the pool. Because all the electronic components need to be housed inside of the ROV's body, it's really important that they're waterproof. For now, the only electronics we expect to come in contact with the water is the motor, which is okay because brushless motors don't have any exposed electrical contacts. In brushless motors, the magnets move around the stator, making them ideal for use in water. So I had this clever idea for a shot at the pool, and now I'm stuck on this stupid pillar out in the middle.